Welcome to the Blue Cafe. We offer stories of infidelity, betrayal, and redemption. Please like and subscribe. Cheers. Now, on to today's story. Girlfriend of nearly 7 years had an emotional affair and I'd give more happened either. Update edit, update at the bottom. Hi, I've been lurking for about a month since I found out what was said in the title. I'm on my throwaway account because we know each other's Reddit. I noticed her texting someone during our holiday together that I had not heard of before and asked her whom it was out of curiosity. She denied what I knew I saw. That was strange that she chose to lie and I know what I saw, so I kept at it until she finally admitted it was someone from work. According to her it was a question about work, during our holiday mind you, but since she was behaving very caught off guard and suspicious of her phone, I asked if there was more and I was starting to get agitated. I had asked to see the conversation to be sure if it was so innocent but she told me she deleted it right there and then. Why the duck, if it was nothing bad or work related? Long story short, after a 4, maybe 5 hour fight and arguing, apparently he had the night before admitted to having a crush on her and she was flattered but refused him, that she was having an emotional affair opening up to him about things we struggled with in our relationship, but nothing else happened she says. She said she felt horrible about talking to him about things between us and realized her mistake right away. Now she's embarrassed, hence the continuous lying to me about what I saw and keeping it from me. This would be easier to believe if she hadn't deleted the evidence and hadn't lied or kept it from me multiple times during the fight we had. Again, embarrassment as an excuse. The bloke is married and 10 years older, she's in a relationship with me. I was just baffled. I've done everything by the book and more. She confirmed that as I've pleaded if there's something I ever did wrong, but no, nothing. Then why the duck is this happening to me? Fast forward a month, to the current time. I've decided to give her a shot at fixing things, being devastated that the woman I thought would never do this to me, did in fact do this to me. She knows I have a history with an ex that cheated multiple times on me. I still don't know for sure if anything physical ever happened between her and this co-worker, and I can't make myself believe her when she swears up and down she didn't go further than what she told me, because she lied during our holiday and fought as well multiple times. Why would now be different? Why now would she be honest, and if nothing more happened, why delete the evidence to back it up? She won't back up her chat history either, because she believes it's in the past now. We need to work on fixing it and that made me lose my collective shit, dares to tell me to move on, the cheater says that. Then, she barely talks or answers when we talk about it and she seems at times unfazed about how critically important this issue is and how close I am to leaving her. I'm the one constantly talking and she just sits there, listening. Does she care at all still? She assured me this is her coping mechanism, knowing she ducked up big time and takes a stance of I'm just letting you vent and rage at me because I know I deserve it, but in my mind, it feels and looks like she doesn't care at all anymore, but she insists she loves me and wants to fix things. It's been a month and I've yet to see anything, including proof or anything that would help her case, nothing. I had found her diary and did the worst thing ever some would say, but I genuinely didn't and still don't care given what pain was caused to me and the uncertainty I'm feeling about my life and future with her as she won't talk, so I read it. Shame me for it, I don't care nor do I regret it. It had a bit written about how she remembers the first time meeting him at the first day of introduction back in March. A big strong man in the doorway with light shining down, who was so open about his life, how they locked eyes and started talking. She ended it with "I want to talk more. So do you." I confronted her but she insisted it's not the way it sounds when you read it, it's just how she writes things. I asked her if she's completely lost her marbles as it obviously reads like a romantic novel but she goes into that cocoon of go ahead and rage, I deserve it and then nothing comes of it, nor a good answer or explanation. What the duck happened between March and June, am I supposed to believe nothing? What with all the uncertainty and her not cooperating at all? I barely sleep and eat anymore, so apologies if this seems like a ramble of words thrown together, I'm just not sure what to do. Is she sincere? You reckon she's honest given her way of handling it? I genuinely don't know anymore. It's like I don't know this woman. I love the woman I know. I've not done anything wrong ever, she tells me. I've given her the world and would give more and more, always have. So why the duck is this happening? Am I overreacting at all? Do I just believe her and move on together, or just move on alone? Update: first of all, I'm overwhelmed with the amount of supportive comments and messages, as well as helpful wake-up calls I've gotten from some. I had confronted her with all of those comments you sent through, after already having gathered evidence to cover my ass, to a point she finally caved and admitted that she did in fact cheat physically and still went behind my back with him. Apparently he was also finalizing his divorce and, well, she was with me, both cheaters. What a surprise. She had thought of breaking up for a while, but according to her she didn't have the guts to do it, so she decided to let me find out, hurt me to no end and let me end it. Being blind for 7 years, I still can't fathom that she continued to lie behind my back even as I was dealing with the worst possible feeling thanks to her. She didn't care. I kicked her out after she packed a bag, and I'm now supposed to sort out everything with her father to handle the apartment and all that, as I've got nothing else in my life such as family. I'm moving to a friend of mine in a neighboring country hopefully sometime soon when everything is finalized. I still can't believe it's all over. Everything was a lie, 7 years of my life, a waste of time. I left everything behind to build a life with her and even move countries and did everything by the book and more, only to have her do this to me and end it all over some bloke she met in March. Cheaters don't change. The only win I get is that they'll eventually cheat on each other too. Just the way these people are. I'm glad I missed a bullet like some said, and might have had it worse with marriage and all that. I'll find peace in that, but right now I'm completely and utterly lost. I thought this was the one, now I'm just done. The infidelity aside, do you really want to spend your life with someone who refuses to address major problems in your relationship? Especially major problems she actually caused? Her coping mechanism screams, "Sorry, Charlie, I don't care enough about you to actually do anything. It's your problem to deal with." Now you know that you're on your own to heal yourself, and she's not going to help you with anything, priced accordingly. Her actions tell you she's unremorseful, regardless of the words she speaks. If you want a shot at saving the relationship, you have got to show her you are willing and able to end it. As she's just a GF, you'd be smart to entertain ending it. You now know she handles getting caught cheating, and it's gonna be a more difficult split if there's marriage and kids involved. If you do stay with her, protect yourself and your assets. If you marry, get a prenuptial. Op, don't say you weren't warned. Trust your gut, treat her as if she had slept with him, and plan your exit strategy. Leave, go North Carolina, and let her actions speak if there's a chance for her. Stop doing the pick me dance, and implement 180/gray rock. Just take your stuff and move out without an explanation or a heads up. Simple as that, and let her know that you know your own value and won't be a doormat. Actions speak louder than words, and when someone tells you who they are, you should believe them. You put up with this shit, and keep her in your life will only give her the right way to do it again, and next time she will be more stealthy. She lied to you before and could easily reassure you and show to you that she isn't lying now by recovering their chats. She says that she wants to fix what she did and to work it out, but is not ready or willing to take the one and most crucial step to get exactly that done. You know that she is still lying and that you only discovered the tip of the iceberg. Does it even matter to you now how much more they did? Isn't her willingness to reassure you, to show you real remorse and to fight for you enough to make a decision? If it isn't enough for you, then the question I would ask you is whether she plans to return to her lover at her job, or if she already told you that she will quit her job and cut her lover out of her life. You are worth so much more than to be treated this way. Based on what you wrote here, it is still going on, or most probably she is still in limbo. Now her being unfazed is because she is pretty sure you will never leave her. You need to go 180, tell her we need to separate. Most importantly, tell this to other man's wife as much as you have right to know. She also needs to know, and this can only put a full stop on the affair, and please don't discuss this with your GF first. She will try to protect that man and try to stop you from telling him. And since she is still working there, I am 100% sure it's going on. Check her work emails and chats, and since they are in the same office, I am pretty sure it is full on physical also. Still working there, I ask about any contact every day. I'd what else to do or even believe it, I feel powerless. She insists there are none, different departments too. You're only powerless because you're giving her the power. She's proven she's a cheater, a liar, and also if she valued you and your relationship, she'd have already quit her job. Also, she can't even deal with relationship issues in an adult manner but just shuts down and doesn't talk. You'd be an idiot to marry her, so why continue the relationship? Report them both to HR, let her affair partner's wife know what's going on, and find somebody worth your time. Based on what you wrote here, it is still going on, or most probably she is still in limbo. Now her being unfazed is because she is pretty sure you will never leave her. You need to go 180, tell her we need to separate. Most importantly, tell this to other man's wife as much as you have right to know. She also needs to know, and this can only put a full stop on the affair, and please don't discuss this with your GF first. She will try to protect that man and try to stop you from telling him. And since she is still working there, I am 100% sure it's going on. Check her work emails and chats, and since they are in the same office, I am pretty sure it is full on physical also. I am pretty sure you are working also, and different departments don't ensure anything. That smells like gaslight. Calm down, come to your own senses. Trust your senses and don't let her tell you what is real and what isn't. Have a good close friend to meet and share. I know it might hurt right now, as you might take a look at her without wearing pink glasses. Sorry, dude. This is on her for lying. You feel horrible having to be the guard. She doesn't want to do the work to help you. Like a cheater, it is all about her. You are upset because you can't understand why she can't see all the lying, etc., is destroying your relationship. Time to sever ties. I know it is 7 years, but she failed the girlfriend test. She's biding her time to test the waters with him to see if he offers more / better than you. By staying with her, you're giving her the power over the relationship while she's deciding her next move. Don't be a pawn in her game. You've seen the evidence. Once they give their heart to someone else, the body will soon follow. It's only a matter of time. Also, her words right now mean less than zero. She's only trying to pacify you as to keep the peace, so please understand that her actions are to be judged, not her words. The more you dig for the truth, the more she will cover it with dirt. You know what you need to do, move on. She has already done so, now it's up to you. Mate, she isn't sincere and you know it. She deleted her conversation with him when you confronted her. What kind of innocent people do that? You're accused of something, and instead of providing something that can prove you are innocent, you delete the evidence that you are guilty. You can probably find some software to recover the conv, it depends on the app that was used, or you can maybe get the call logs from your phone provider. Mate, trust your gut, you know something is wrong. Go talk with a lawyer just in case, and don't tell her, and if you can find the guy's wife and tell her everything, she might be able to collect evidence from her end. I'm seriously trying to do anything I can and find out the truth. Right now everything is such a blur. It would help if she could get over the guilty sad post behavior and help me prove her words are true, but she's not engaging with it so far. I know you have good points, it just hurts to see 7 years of work and sacrifice go away and do that suddenly. It was through WhatsApp. Also, I've been desperately trying to find his wife. She's living a lie and I can't live with knowing that and not doing anything. She could get over the guilty sad pose behavior. Chances are this is just an act of self-preservation and manipulation to get you to back off and rug sweep her behavior. It appears her answer to fixing this is make herself a victim. Look up the term DAVO. 7 years is nothing compared to a lifetime of constant worry over fidelity, loyalty, integrity with her as a wife, with kids, and a mortgage. She's not guilty, don't buy that. I know you have good points, it just hurts to see 7 years of work and sacrifice go away and do that suddenly. And now imagine how she smiled each time when she saw that guy, talked to him and texted him. How she smiled when she realized that boundaries are overstepped and that this might lead to the breakup of the 7-year relationship if you find out. Imagine how happy she was and never planned to stop it until you found out. It hurts you to see how these 7 years go away while she enjoyed every second of it. That is the difference between you and her, or one of the many. You don't need evidence to know that she's cheating. If she wants to prove her innocence to you, all she has to do is back up her phone and show you the deleted messages. She won't. Because the messages aren't innocent. With them working together, the affair is very likely continuing. We hope you have enjoyed today's episode. Please comment, like and subscribe. Cheers. Have a wonderful day or night. Wherever you are.